In this video, we're given the formula for the centripetal acceleration. So that's v squared over r, where v is the speed of an object moving in a circular path, and r is the radius of curvature. And we're told that we measure the speed as 2.34 plus 0.05 meters per second, and the radius of curvature as 25.5 plus or minus 0.1 centimeters. Now, provided we measure the speed in meters per second and the radius in meters, we're going to get the proper units of meters per second squared for this acceleration. And that means we should probably convert that radius of curvature to meters immediately. So that's 0.255 plus or minus 0.001 meters. And then the question here is really about how do I compute the uncertainty in the centripetal acceleration properly by using propagation of errors formulas? And it's broken into two parts. What we want to start with is finding the acceleration in meters per second squared. And I'm asked to just keep some extra precision for now. So I'm told to keep four significant digits. So a is v squared over r. That's 2.34 squared over 0.255. And this gives me 21.47 meters per second squared. Part b is the real meat of the problem. I want to use a propagation of error formula to compute the uncertainty in the centripetal acceleration. And I have an a that's proportional to v squared and r to the negative 1. If I write that 1 over r in terms of exponents, and I apply my propagation of errors formula, I'll post a link to the video where I first introduced this. And the exponent on each of these factors comes out in front. So I have a 2 and then the uncertainty in v divided by v itself. And that's all squared. In the second term, again, I bring the exponent out in front, but that's a negative 1. And when I square it, it just goes away. So I'm not even going to write it. And I have a delta r over r all squared. And when I plug in the numbers for the first term, that's a 2 times 0.05 over 2.34 all squared. And in the second term, 0.001 over 0.255 all squared. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 0.0429. Now, this is actually telling you the relative uncertainty in A. In other words, if I shifted the decimal point two places, I'm talking about roughly a 4% error. I still have to find the uncertainty in A itself. And to get that done, I have to multiply both sides by A. So delta A is going to be A times 0.0429. That's 21.47 times 0.0429. And this gives me about 0.921. And that has units on it. That's meters per second squared. So there's the uncertainty in A. Now our convention is to round uncertainties to one significant digit. So that's 0.9 meters per second squared. And then go back and round the original quantity to the same decimal place that is addressed by the uncertainty. So I'm going to round this thing to the tenths place. And I have my final answer for the centripetal acceleration. That's 21.5, because the tenths place is the place value addressed by the uncertainty, plus or minus 0.9 meters per second squared. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.